हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर एलिमेंट ऑफ ग्रुप 16, 17 एंड 18. इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे इज आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज एनामलस बिहेवियर ऑफ फ्लोरीन. एज यू नो व्हाट इज एनामलस बिहेवियर मींस सेम ग्रुप एटम बट हैविंग डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज. हियर फ्लोरीन इज द फर्स्ट मेंबर ऑफ ग्रुप 17 एंड differ in properties from the other members of the group. So why the properties of fluorine is different from the other member of the group is, number one, fluorine having a small atomic size. Second, fluorine having high electronegativity. In fluorine there is absence of d orbitals in valence shell and low ff bond dissociation enthalpy. Because of all these four reasons, small atomic size, high electronegativity, absence of d orbitals in valence shell and low ff bond dissociation enthalpy, fluorine is differ from the other member of the group and it is known as anomalous behavior of fluorine. There are some anomalous properties of fluorine, for example, ionization enthalpy, electronegativity, electrode potential. These all are the higher for fluorine, means ionization enthalpy, electronegativity and electrode potential. These properties are higher for fluorine than the other halogen. Similarly, ionic and covalent radii, melting point, boiling point and electron gain enthalpy are lower in fluorine than other halogen or than expected. Most of the reaction of fluorine are exothermic. As you know, what is exothermic means the reaction in which heat is evolved. Fluorine form only oxo acid while other halogen form a number of oxo acid, means fluorine form only one of the oxo acid HOF and other halogen form a number of oxo acid. Hydrogen fluoride means HF is a liquid and having boiling point 293 Kelvin. Hydrogen fluoride is a liquid due to strong hydrogen bonding while other hydrogen halides are gases. So these are the some reasons because of which fluorine is differ from the other member of halogen. The next topic in this chapter is chemical properties of element of group 16, 17 and 18. In this, the first property is oxidation state. So in group 16, first we are going to study the oxidation state in group 16. So all of you know, in group 16 the valence shell electronic configuration is ns2np4, means s orbital having 2 electron and p orbital having 4 electron. So they attain a noble gas configuration either by gaining 2 electron. All of you know how the atom can attain a noble gas configuration if their octet is complete, means if atom having 8 electron in their valence shell, so they attain a noble gas configuration. So the group 16 element attain a noble gas configuration either by gaining 2 electron, so they can form e-2 ions, or by sharing 2 electron forming 2 covalent bond. So these elements generally show -2 and +2 oxidation state. -2 by sharing 2 electron or by gaining 2 electron, or +2 by sharing or by losing 2 electron. So generally group 16 element having 2 oxidation state, it is -2 and +2. Students, all of you know how these charges can be formed on the atoms. If you gain an electron, if any element gain an electron, so it forms negative charge. If any elements or atom lose the electron, so it forms positive charge. Oxygen is highly electronegative. It means oxygen can attract the share pair of electron from the other elements. So oxygen show minus 2 oxidation state, except two cases, OF2. In OF2 oxidation state of oxygen is plus 2, and in peroxide. In peroxide oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1. Students, oxygen is highly electronegative, that's why it attracts a share pair of electron from the other elements. So it's always show minus 2 oxidation state. But in OF2, the oxidation state of oxygen is plus 2. And in peroxide, the oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1. So these are the two different cases for oxygen. Other elements of the group exhibit plus 2, 4, 6 oxidation state. With plus 4 and plus 6 oxidation state is more common in group 16 element. The stability of higher plus 6 oxidation state decreases down the group, while the stability of lower oxidation state plus 4 increases down the group due to inert perifect. Bonding in plus 4 and plus 6 oxidation state are primarily covalent. So these are the nothing but oxidation state of group 16 element. The next topic is the oxidation state of group 17 element. Group 17 element are represented by the valence electronic shell configuration as NS2NP5. As it is clearly seen, NS2NP5, so they can attain noble gas configuration by either gaining one electron, means S orbital having 2 electron and P orbital having 5 electron. And we all of you clearly, or we already studied earlier, that P orbital having total 6 electron. So P orbital take 1 electron and complete their octet. So the electronic configuration will be NS2NP5. Instead of NS2NP5, it will become NS2NP6. S orbital is completed, P orbital is completed. Student, always remember, S orbital containing 2 electrons, so it is completed. P orbital containing 6 electrons, so it is completed. Here, S orbital having 2 electrons in group 17 and P orbital having 5 electrons. So, for complete their orbital, group 17 element containing 1 electron. So group 17 element gaining 1 electron and forming E minus ion, or by sharing 1 electron forming 1 covalent bond. All halogen exhibit minus 1 oxidation state. Chlorine, bromine, iodine exhibit plus 1, plus 3, plus 5 and plus 7 oxidation state as well. Why? Because they are less electronegative than fluorine and possess empty d orbital in the valence shell, and therefore can expand the octet. The oxidation state plus 4 and plus 6 occur in the oxide and oxo acid of fluorine and bromine. Fluorine atom has no d orbital in the valence shell and therefore cannot expand its octet. Thus, fluorine being most electronegative and exhibit only minus 1 oxidation state. So these are the information about the group 17 element or oxidation state of group 17 element. Next, oxidation state of group 18 element. As you know, group 18 means noble gases, and noble gases are very much stable, means they have a stable valence shell electronic configuration NS2NP6 with completely filled orbital. They have no tendency to gain or lose electron, that is, they are zero valent and mostly exist as monoatomic gases. However, xenon has large atomic size and lower ionization enthalpy as compared to helium, neon, argon and krypton. Hence, xenon exhibit higher oxidation state. Its outermost shell has d orbital. The paired electron of the valence shell can be unpaired and promoted to empty d orbital. The unpaired electrons are shared with fluorine or oxygen atom and covalent compound showing higher oxidation state. Most of the examples are given in your textbook for xenon. Except xenon, remaining noble gases does not show any such type of compound. They are stable. Only xenon show such type of compound because xenon exhibit higher oxidation state and outermost shell or xenon having d orbital. Or this d orbital paired electron can be unpaired and promote to empty d orbital. So these are the information about the oxidation state of group 18 element. The next topic in this chapter is chemical reactivity towards hydrogen. Means how group 16, 17 and 18 elements react with hydrogen. So the element of group 16 react with hydrogen and they form hydride, and the type of hydride is H2E. For example, H2O, H2S, H2SE, H2TE and many of the compounds. From which H2O is a colorless, odorless liquid, all of you know. While H2S, H2SE, H2TE, H2PO, student, all of you know H2S. H2 means hydrogen gas, S means sulfide. H2SE, H2 means hydrogen, S is selenium, means selenide. H2 hydrogen gas, TE, tellurium. H2 hydrogen gas, PO, polonium. So these are the colorless, bad smelling, poisonous gases at ambient condition. All hydride have angular structure with involved sp3 hybridization of central atom. So shortly, group 16 element react with hydrogen and form hydride, and the type of hydride in which hydrogen atom H2 and the group 16 element like H2O, H2S. This type of hydride group 16 element form, and this type of hydride having angular structure which involve sp3 hybridization of central atom. Another property of this hydride is these hydrides are weakly acidic. The acidic character of this hydride increases while thermal stability decreases from H2O to H2TE. Why the thermal stability decreases? Because of decrease in the bond dissociation enthalpy of the hydrogen and metal bond down the group. All hydride except water possess reducing property. So these are the some properties of hydride of group 16 element. Next, group 17 element. So group 17 element also react with hydrogen and they form hydrogen halides. For example, H2X2, all of you know H2 hydrogen, X means halogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So they form hydrogen halide means HX. So acidic strength of halogen acids increases from HF to HI, means HF is weak acidic strain, HCl is having greater acidic strain than HF, HBr is having greater acidic strain than HCl, and HI having greater acidic strain than HBr. Similarly, due to decreasing bond dissociation enthalpy of hydrogen halide, the hydrogen halide bond in the order of due to decreasing bond dissociation enthalpy of hydrogen halide bond, the order is HF having greater dissociation enthalpy than HCl, then HBr and then HF. थर्मल स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड डिक्रीजेज इन द ऑर्डर ऑफ एच एफ ग्रेटर देन एच सी एल ग्रेटर देन एच बी आर ग्रेटर देन एच आई. इट इज ड्यू टू डिक्रीज इन बॉन्ड एसोसिएशन एंथैल्पी ऑफ हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड बॉन्ड डाउन द ग्रुप. सो दीज आर दी प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड. द नेक्स्ट ग्रुप 18 एलिमेंट नोबल गैसेज. ऑल ऑफ यू नो नोबल गैसेज आर केमिकली इनर्ट टूवर्ड्स हाइड्रोजन ड्यू टू देयर स्टेबल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिग्रेशन. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन दिस चैप्टर इज रिएक्टिविटी टूवर्ड्स ऑक्सीजन. सो ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट मीन्स हाउ द ग्रुप 16, 17 एंड 18 एलिमेंट्स रिएक्ट विद ऑक्सीजन. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट. ऑल द एलिमेंट ऑफ ग्रुप 16 फॉर्म ऑक्साइड एंड द टाइप ऑफ ऑक्साइड इज EO2. फॉर एग्जाम्पल EO2 एंड EO3. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ई. ई मीन्स एलिमेंट. एलिमेंट ऑफ ग्रुप 16 हियर ई. E shows the element of group 16 means sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. So in place of sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, we are using a E. And the form of oxide is EO2 and EO3. For example, SO2, SeO2 or SO3, SeO3. First we are going to study EO2 type oxide. EO2 type oxide means ozone O3 and sulfur dioxide O2 are gases, while selenium dioxide is solid. They are acidic in nature and react with water to form acid. Reducing properties of dioxide decrease from SO2 to TeO2. SO2 is reducing while TeO2 serves as an oxidizing agent. I hope you all are understand reducing property of dioxide. Dioxide means SO2, SeO2, TeO2, PoO2. These are the dioxide. So the reducing properties of dioxide decrease from SO2 to TeO2. Means SO2 is reducing agent while TeO2 serves as an oxidizing agent. EO3 type oxide means SO3, SeO3, TeO3. These types are nothing but EO3. These are acidic in nature. They dissolve in water and form acid. So there are two type of oxide. Means when group 16 element react with oxygen, they form two type of oxide. First is EO2 and another is EO3. As I have already explained that E means element of group 16. Group 17 element. So group 17 element means halogen. They also form oxide with oxygen, but most of them are unstable. Fluorine form two oxide OF2 and O2F2. However, only the OF2 is thermally stable at 298 Kelvin. In fact, both are strong fluorinating agent. O2F2 oxidizes plutonium to PuF6. And the reaction is used in removing plutonium as PuF6 from spent nuclear fuel. Chlorine oxide means Cl2O, ClO2, Cl2O6 and Cl2O7. These all are the highly reactive oxidizing agent and tend to explode. ClO2 is used as bleaching agent for paper pulp and textile and in water treatment. Bromine oxide, Br2O, BrO2, BrO3 are the less stable halogen oxide. They are very powerful oxidizing agent. Iodine oxide, I2O4, I2O5 and I2O7, these are insoluble solid and decomposes on heating. I2O5 is a very good oxidizing agent and used for the estimation of carbon monoxide. The higher oxide of halogen are more stable than lowers. So these are the properties of group 17 elements when they react with oxygen and they form oxide. ग्रुप 18 एलिमेंट. एज यू नो नोबल गैसेस एलिमेंट आर केमिकली इनर्ट एंड डू नॉट डायरेक्टली रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन. द नेक्स्ट रिएक्शन रिएक्टिविटी टूवर्ड्स हेलोजन मीन्स हाफ द ग्रुप 16, 17 and 18 रिएक्ट विथ हेलोजन. सो इन ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट रिएक्ट विथ हेलोजन एंड दे फॉर्म डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ हैलाइड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल EX6, EX4, EX2. E मीन्स एलिमेंट ऑफ ग्रुप 16 एंड X मीन्स हेलोजन. सो EX6 फॉर एग्जाम्पल SF6, EX4 फॉर एग्जाम्पल TeCl4, EX2 फॉर एग्जाम्पल S2Cl2. सो दिस टाइप्स ऑफ द कंपाउंड ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट कैन बी फॉर्म विद द हेलोजन. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हेक्सा हैलाइड मीन्स वैन ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट रिएक्ट विद 6 हेलोजन एटम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल SF6 हियर 6 फ्लोरिन रिएक्ट विद सल्फर SF6, SEF6, TEF6. They are formed by direct combination. They are colorless gases and they have sp3d2 hybridization and possess octahedral structure. SF6 is exceptionally stable halide for steric reason. Stability of halide decreases in the order means fluoride having more stable stability than chloride, then bromide, then iodine. Next is tetrahalide. Tetrahalide means SF4, SEF4, TEF4, TECl2. These all are the tetra, means 4 halogen atom. Having sp3 hybridization and thus trigonal bipyramidal geometry with one equatorial position occupied by a lone pair. Dihalide, for example, 2 halogen atom means SCl2, SECl2, TECl2 having sp3 hybridization and thus possess tetrahedral structure with 2 equatorial position occupied by lone pair. Monohalides are dimeric in nature, for example, S2F2, S2Cl2, SE2Cl2 and SEBr2. These dimeric halides undergo disproportionation. These are the group 17 element which react with halogen and form different types of halide. Now next is group 17 element. So group 17 element combines themselves to form a number of compound known as interhalogen compound. When group 17 element react, because group 17 are halogen and they again react with halogen, so they form interhalogen compound, and type of interhalogen compounds are XX-, XX-3, XX-5, XX-7, where X is the halogen atom with larger size and X- is the halogen atom with smaller size. Now group 18, so group 18 element means noble gases, they are chemically inert. Krypton and xenon however react directly with fluorine to form fluoride. For example, xenon react with fluorine and form XeF2. Xenon fluoride, they form XeF4, XeF6. These xenon fluorides are crystalline and colorless, which sublime readily and at 298 Kelvin. They are powerful fluorinating agent. Next topic in this chapter is reactivity towards metal. So group 16 element react with metal and form their corresponding compound. For example, oxygen react with aluminium form aluminium trioxide. Selenium react with magnesium form magnesium selenide. So they form their corresponding compound. Group 17 element means halogen when react with metal instantly they give metal halide. For example, NaCl, MgBr2, etc. Ionic character of halides increases in the order means fluorine react readily, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine with the metal. द मेटल हैलाइड हैविंग मेटल इन देयर हायर ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट आर मोर कोवेलेंट देन वंस हैविंग मेटल इन लोअर ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट. ग्रुप 18 एलिमेंट्स, सो ग्रुप 18 एलिमेंट्स आर द नोबल गैसेस एंड डू नॉट डायरेक्टली रिएक्ट विथ मेटल. सो दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज, केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ग्रुप 16, 17 एंड 18 एलिमेंट्स. द नेक्स्ट इज द एलोट्रॉपी. ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज एलोट्रॉपी. एलिमेंट ऑफ द ग्रुप 16 एग्जिबिट एलोट्रॉपी. ऑक्सीजन हैज टू एलोट्रॉप्स. द कॉमन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एलोट्रॉपी इज कार्बन. कार्बन फॉर्म टू एलोट्रॉप्स, वन इज डायमंड एंड अनदर इज ग्रेफाइट. ऑल ऑफ यू नो दिस. सेम हियर, एलिमेंट ऑफ ग्रुप 16 एग्जिबिट एलोट्रॉपी. ऑक्सीजन हैविंग टू एलोट्रॉप्स, O2 एंड O3. सल्फर एग्जिस्ट इन अ नंबर ऑफ एलोट्रॉपिक फॉर्म, एग्जाम्पल रोम्बिक, मोनोक्लोनिक एंड मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर. एक्चुअली रोम्बिक एंड मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट एलोट्रॉप्स ऑफ सल्फर बट आर नॉन मेटेलिक. सेलेनियम एग्जिस्ट इन टू एलोट्रॉपिक फॉर्म, रेड विच इज नॉन मेटेलिक एंड ग्रे विच इज मेटेलिक. टर्लियम एग्जिस्ट इन टू एलोट्रॉपिक फॉर्म, क्रिस्टलाइन एंड अमॉर्फस. एंड लास्ट पोलोनियम रिवेल्स टू एलोट्रॉपिक फॉर्म, अल्फा एंड बीटा. दिस बोथ आर दी मेटेलिक. सो दिस आर दी इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दी एलोट्रॉप्स ऑफ ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एलोट्रॉप्स ऑफ सल्फर. सी इन दिस टेबल यू कैन क्लियरली डिस्टिंग्विश द टू एलोट्रॉप्स ऑफ सल्फर. फर्स्ट इज रोम्बिक सल्फर मीन्स अल्फा सल्फर एंड अनदर इज मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर मीन्स बीटा सल्फर. देर आर मैनी ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज विच आर वी शो द डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन दिस टू सल्फर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल कलर ऑफ रोम्बिक सल्फर इज पेल येलो एंड मोनोक्लोनिक सल्फर इज ब्राइट येलो सॉलिड. शेप ऑर्थोरोम्बिक क्रिस्टल फॉर रोम्बिक सल्फर एंड मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर इज नीडल शेप. मेल्टिंग पॉइंट 385.8 केल्विन फॉर रोम्बिक सल्फर एंड मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर 393 केल्विन. डेंसिटी, सॉलिबिलिटी, स्टेबिलिटी, नेचर, मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन, दिस ऑल दिस टेबल इज क्लियरली शो द डिस्टिंग्विश ऑफ दिस टू सल्फर. सो यू हैव टू स्टडी द टेबल विच इज द डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन रोम्बिक सल्फर एंड मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर. Now the next topic is oxo acid. Oxo acid of sulfur. As all of you know, sulfur form a number of oxo acid in which some of them are unstable and cannot be isolated. They are known to exist in aqueous solution or if they form salt. Some important oxo acids are, the first is sulfurous acid means H2SO3. The structure means sulfur having double bond with oxygen, single bond with OH and having two lone pair of electron. Double bond with oxygen, single bond with OH and one lone pair of electron. Another oxo acid of sulfur is sulfuric acid H2SO4, in which sulfur having double bond with oxygen and single bond with OH. Next, di or pyrosulfuric acid. As structure is shown, the formula is H2S2O7. H2S2O7, in which oxygen-oxygen bond is also there. Sulfur-oxygen bond is also there. Sulfur having double bond with oxygen and single bond with OH. OH means hydroxyl group. Next, fourth one is peroxymonosulfuric acid means H2SO5. Similar here, sulfur in double bond with oxygen and single bond with OH or OOH. Next one is peroxydisulfuric acid means H2S2O8. Here two lone pairs are there and similarly sulfur oxygen bond is there. Sulfur oxygen sulfur bond is there. सल्फर ऑक्सीजन बॉन्ड इज देयर एंड सल्फर OH बॉन्ड इज देयर. लास्ट इज थायोसल्फ्यूरिक एसिड मीन्स H2H2O3. सल्फर सल्फर बॉन्ड इज देयर, सल्फर ऑक्सीजन बॉन्ड इज देयर एंड सल्फर OH बॉन्ड इज देयर. सो दिस आर दी ऑक्सो एसिड ऑफ सल्फर. फर्स्ट ऑलवेज रिमेंबर सल्फर फॉर्म अ नंबर ऑफ ऑक्सो एसिड. सम ऑफ देम आर अनस्टेबल एंड कैन नॉट बी आइसोलेटेड एंड दे आर नोन टू एग्जिस्ट इन एक्वस सोल्यूशन और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ देयर सॉल्ट. एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑक्सो एसिड आर सल्फ्यूरस एसिड, सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, डाई और पायरोसल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, परऑक्सी मोनोसल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, परऑक्सी डायसल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एंड लास्ट थायोसल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑक्सो एसिड ऑफ हेलोजन. हेलोजन फॉर्म सेवरल ऑक्सो एसिड. ओनली 4 ऑक्सो एसिड हैव बीन आइसोलेटेड इन प्योर फॉर्म. दीज आर हाइपोफ्लोरस एसिड मीन्स HOF, परक्लोरिक एसिड मीन्स HClO4, आयोडिक एसिड मीन्स HIO3, मेटा पर आयोडिक एसिड मीन्स H2IO6. द अदर आर स्टेबल ओनली इन एक्वस सोल्यूशन और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ देयर सॉल्ट. स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑक्सो एसिड ऑफ क्लोरिन आर सी आर हाइपोक्लोरस एसिड HOCl. नेक्स्ट वन इज क्लोरस एसिड मीन्स HOClO और HClO2 मीन्स HOCl डबल बॉन्ड हो मीन्स क्लोरिन हैविंग 1 डबल बॉन्ड एंड 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड. नेक्स्ट इज क्लोरिक एसिड मीन्स HClO3. द स्ट्रक्चर इज HOCl डबल क्लोरिन हैविंग डबल बॉन्ड 2 डबल बॉन्ड विथ ऑक्सीजन, 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड विथ हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन हैविंग क्लोरिन हैविंग 2 डबल बॉन्ड विथ ऑक्सीजन, क्लोरिन हैविंग 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड विथ ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑक्सीजन हैविंग 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड विथ हाइड्रोजन. नेक्स्ट इज पर क्लोरिक एसिड मीन्स HClE4 एंड द स्ट्रक्चर इज क्लोरिन हैविंग डबल बॉन्ड विथ 3 डबल बॉन्ड विथ ऑक्सीजन, 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड विथ ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑक्सीजन हैविंग 1 सिंगल बॉन्ड विथ हाइड्रोजन. सो दिस आर द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑक्सो एसिड ऑफ क्लोरिन. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज कंपाउंड ऑफ सल्फर. सो इन द कंपाउंड ऑफ सल्फर द फर्स्ट कंपाउंड इज सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड मीन्स SO2. सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड मीन्स SO2. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रिपरेशन. सो द फर्स्ट प्रिपरेशन इज फ्रॉम सल्फर. सिंपल प्रिपरेशन इज दैट सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड गैस कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय बर्निंग सल्फर इन एयर. सो इजिली सल्फर इज बर्निंग विद एयर एंड फॉर्म सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. सेकेंड प्रिपेरेशन लेबोरेटरी मैटर मीन्स फ्रॉम सल्फाइड. सो सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड इज प्रिपेयर बाय ट्रीटिंग सोडियम सल्फाइड विथ डायल्यूट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. सो वी विल गेट सोडियम सल्फेट प्लस वाटर एंड प्लस सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. नेक्स्ट प्रिपरेशन अगेन इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड मीन्स सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय रोस्टिंग जिंक सल्फाइड एंड आयरन पायराइड. रोस्टिंग मीन्स रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन. सो जिंक सल्फाइड रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन गैस एंड फॉर्म जिंक ऑक्साइड एंड सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. आयरन पायराइड मीन्स FeS2. इट इज अगेन रोस्टिंग विथ ऑक्सीजन एंड फॉर्म आयरन ऑक्साइड एंड सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. सो दिस आर द 3 मेथड्स बाय विच वी कैन प्रिपेयर सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. फर्स्ट फ्रॉम सल्फर, सेकेंड फ्रॉम सल्फाइड एंड थर्ड फ्रॉम सल्फाइड. द नेक्स्ट इज फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सल्फर. सो फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड. सो सल्फर डाई ऑक्साइड इज अ कलरलेस गैस विथ अ पंजन स्मेल. इट इज पॉइजनस इन नेचर, हाईली सॉल्युबल इन वाटर, and its solution in water is called sulfurous acid. It's liquefied room temperature under a pressure of 2 atmosphere and boil at 263 Kelvin. The next topic is a chemical properties of sulfur dioxide. First, reaction with water. So when sulfur react with water, as you have seen in the reaction, they react in presence of charcoal, means sulfur dioxide gas react with chlorine gas in presence of charcoal, which act as a catalyst and they form sulfuryl chloride. Simple reaction is that. Okay, next one, reaction with oxygen. So when sulfur dioxide is oxidized by oxygen, or you can say dioxygen, in presence of vanadium oxide, vanadium fifth oxide, so they form sulfur trioxide. Easy reaction is that 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas, they form 2SO3 gas in presence of V2O5. Next, when sulfur dioxide react with NaOH, means sodium hydroxide solution, they form sodium sulfide with the removal of water. Next, reaction with sodium sulfite. When sulfur dioxide react with sodium sulfite solution, that's why you are using H2O liquid. Means sulfur dioxide react with sodium sulfite solution, so they form sodium hydrogen sulfide. Sodium hydrogen sulfide. Next, reducing property. So sulfur dioxide act as a reducing agent in presence of moisture. Moist sulfur dioxide reduce ferric salt into ferrous salt, and the example is, see here, 2Fe3 plus means SO2 plus 2H2O. SO2 plus 2H2O means moist sulfur dioxide, and Fe3 plus means ferric salt, and this moist sulfur dioxide reduce ferric salt to ferrous salt, means Fe2 plus. Fe3 plus means ferric and Fe2 plus means ferrous. Next, moist sulfur dioxide decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate 7 solution. It is potassium permanganate solution. Sulfur dioxide, moist sulfur dioxide, this moist sulfur dioxide decolorize this potassium permanganate solution, and they form potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate and H2SO4. Similarly, moist sulfur dioxide again reduces halogen to halogen acid. See here, I2 is the halogen, sulfur dioxide, water means moist sulfur dioxide, and they form sulfuric acid plus HI. HI is nothing but a halogen acid, and the name of this halogen acid is hydrogen iodide. Or the next structure of SO2. So sulfur dioxide is angular with OSO bond angle of 119.5 degree. Just see the structure, both are the correct, in which the sulfur oxygen double bond arises from D pi P pi bonding. It is a resonance hybrid of two canonical form. Next topic in this is uses of sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is used in refining of petroleum and sugar, bleaching wool and silk, anti-color, disinfectant, preservative, in the manufacture of H2SO4 and sodium hydrogen sulfide. Liquid SO2 is used as a solvent to dissolve a number of organic and inorganic chemicals. So this is the first element of sulfur. This is all about the information of first element of sulfur, and the name of this element is, sorry, first compound of sulfur, and the name of the compound is SO2 sulfur dioxide. द नेक्स्ट कंपाउंड ऑफ सल्फर इज सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड H2SO4. यू ऑल आर अवेयर अबाउट H2SO4. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द प्रिपेरेशन ऑफ H2SO4 मीन्स सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. एंड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड इज मैन्युफैक्चर बाय कॉन्टैक्ट प्रोसेस विच इन्वॉल्व 3 स्टेप. इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप सी हियर, इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप सल्फर और सल्फाइड ओर मीन्स आयरन पायराइड बर्निंग और रोस्टिंग इन एयर एंड प्रोड्यूसेस सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. द रिएक्शन इज सल्फर प्लस ऑक्सीजन एंड दे फॉर्म सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. एंड व्हेन आयरन पायराइड इज यूज सो इट अगेन फॉर्म सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. मीन्स इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर फर्स्ट सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड बाई यूजिंग सल्फर और आयरन पायराइड. इन द सेकेंड स्टेप सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड इज ऑक्सीडाइजेस कैटालिटिकली विथ ऑक्सीजन एंड दे फॉर्म सल्फर ट्राइऑक्साइड. सी हियर, दिस सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड कैटालिटिकली ऑक्सीडाइजेस द कैटलिस्ट. यू हैव सीन V2O5 इज द कैटलिस्ट. Oxidizes means react with oxygen and they form sulfur trioxide. Means in the first step we have to prepare sulfur dioxide and in the second step we have to prepare sulfur trioxide. The reaction is exothermic and reversible. All of you know what is exothermic and reversible. And the forward reaction lead to decreases in volume. Next, the third step means sulfur trioxide gas which absorb in concentrated sulfur trioxide gas is absorbed in concentrated H2SO form and to produce oleum. See here the reaction sulfur trioxide gas absorbed in concentrated H2SO form 4 and form oleum means H2S2O7. This oleum means H2S2O7 is dilute with water and they form sulfuric acid of desired concentration. So the sulfuric acid obtained by contact process, in which in first step sulfur dioxide is formed, in second step sulfur trioxide is formed, in third step first we have to form oleum. This oleum diluted with water and form H2SO4 and we will get 96% to 98% pure sulfuric acid. Next topic is physical properties of sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is colorless, dense, oily liquid. It has density of 1.84 gram per centimeter cube at 298 Kelvin. It freezes at 283 Kelvin and boils at 611 Kelvin. It is highly corrosive and produces severe burn on the skin. Next is the chemical properties of sulfuric acid. So the first property is the acidic property. Sulfuric acid ionizes in aqueous solution in 2 steps. Means when we dissolve sulfuric acid in water, so it is ionizes in 2 steps. Means H2SO4 react with water and form hydronium ion. Means it form H3O plus, it form HSO4. Then this HSO4 react with H2O. So it form H3O plus and SO4 2 minus. Both the reaction having Ka value, means dissociation constant of acid value. First reaction having K value greater than 10 and second reaction having K value equal to 1.2 into 10 is 2 minus 2. The greater value of K means that H2SO4 is largely dissociated into H plus ion and HSO4 ion. Thus H2SO4 is a strong acid. Greater K value means where Ka is greater than 10. Reaction with metal and non-metal, and you can say oxidizing properties. So metal and non-metals both are oxidized by hot concentrated sulfuric acid. which itself get reduced through sulfur dioxide. For example, see the reaction when copper is a metal, it is react with hot concentrated sulfuric acid, so it's form copper sulfide or copper sulfate and sulfur dioxide and water. Means sulfuric acid with itself reduces and forms sulfur dioxide. The next example with the sulfur, when sulfur react with hot concentrated H2SO4, again H2SO4 with itself reduces form sulfur dioxide and water. Again next example is with carbon. When carbon react with hot concentrated sulfuric acid, again sulfuric acid get reduces itself from sulfur dioxide and remaining is carbon dioxide and water. Next property, chemical property of sulfuric acid is dehydrating property. Concentrated sulfuric acid is a strong dehydrating agent. Means sulfuric acid easily remove water from sugar and carbohydrate. Carbon left behind is called sugar charcoal and the process is called charring. See here, carbohydrate means C6 sugar, you can use sugar or carbohydrate. Here C12H22O11, it is a sugar, all of you know, which is react with hot concentrated H2SO4 as a dehydrating agent. Water molecule is removed and the carbon which is left behind is nothing but a sugar charcoal. Next chemical property of sulfuric acid, reaction with salt. So whenever concentrated sulfuric acid decomposes the salt of more volatile acid to the corresponding acid. See here NaCl react with H2SO4. So H2SO4 decomposes NaCl and form acid, means HCl. Potassium nitrate and H2SO4, so H2SO4 decomposes potassium nitrate and form nitric acid. H2SO4 react with calcium fluoride, it decomposes calcium fluoride and form hydrogen fluoride. So from the reaction it is clearly seen that whenever concentrated sulfuric acid decomposes the salt of more volatile acid to the corresponding acid is formed. The next topic is uses of sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is very important industrial chemical. It is used in the manufacture of fertilizer, for example ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, etc. It is used in the manufacture of pigment, paints, dyes, stuff, intermediate. It is used in petroleum refining. It is used in detergent industry, in metallurgy, cleaning of metal, electroplating and galvanizing. It is used in storage batteries. It is used as a laboratory reagent. So many of the uses are there for sulfuric acid. The next topic is chlorine and compound of chlorine. First, we are going to study chlorine. Chlorine was the topic is preparation of chlorine. So chlorine can be prepared by oxidation of hydrochloric acid with any of the following oxidizing agent. For example, manganese dioxide. When manganese dioxide react with hydrochloric acid is formed manganese chloride, chlorine and water. So we can prepare chlorine by oxidation of hydrochloric acid, means HCl, by using manganese dioxide. Again we are using hydrochloric acid or hydrochloric acid with potassium वी आर प्रिपेरिंग क्लोरीन विथ पोटाशियम पर मैग्नेट मीन्स द ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड विथ पोटाशियम पर मैग्नेट. ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड विथ पोटाशियम पर मैग्नेट सो वी विल गेट द क्लोरीन इजिली. क्लोरीन कैन ऑल्सो बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द एक्शन ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड ऑन अ मिक्सचर ऑफ सोडियम क्लोराइड एंड मैग्नीज डाइऑक्साइड. सी द रिएक्शन इज अ टू स्टेप रिएक्शन. इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप सोडियम क्लोराइड रिएक्ट विथ H2SO4 विथ फॉर्म सोडियम हाइड्रोजन सल्फेट प्लस हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड. This hydrogen chloride react with manganese dioxide, so it form chlorine. The net cell reaction or in the overall cell reaction, we will get 4 sodium chloride, 1 manganese dioxide and 4 sulfuric acid react together and form sodium hydrogen sulfide plus manganese chloride plus water, and at the end we will get the chlorine. Next topic in this chapter is manufacture of chlorine. So in manufacture of chlorine, the first process is Deakin process. In Deakin process, chlorine is manufactured by the oxidation of hydrogen chloride means HCl by atmospheric oxygen in presence of cuprous chloride as a catalyst at 273 Kelvin. See in the reaction, hydrogen chloride oxidized by atmospheric oxygen in presence of cuprous chloride as a catalyst at 723 Kelvin and it's formed chlorine and water. Another manufacture is electrolytic process. So in electrolytic process or by electrolytic process of concentrated NaCl solution means brine, in electrolysis concentrated NaCl solution means brine is used and chlorine is liberated as anode. See in the reaction, NaCl break in sodium ion and chlorine ion. So at cathode, water molecule undergo reduction and form H2N2OH-. Sodium ion react with OH- and form NaOH. At anode, chlorine undergo oxidation, it remove electron and form chlorine gas. So it is a simple process or electrolytic process. So in the manufacture of chlorine, there are two processes. One is Deakin process and another is electrolytic process. Next topic is physical properties of chlorine. So chlorine is a greenish yellow gas having pungent and suffocating odor. It is poisonous in nature. It dissolves in water to give chlorine water. It is 2 to 5 times heavier than air. The next topic is chemical properties of chlorine. In chemical properties of chlorine, the first property, however chlorine react with metal. Whenever chlorine react with metal, they form chloride. See in the reaction, aluminium react with chlorine form aluminium chloride. Sodium react with chlorine form sodium chloride. Iron react with chlorine form iron chloride. Similarly, reaction with non-metal, whenever chlorine react with non-metal, they form their chloride again. For example, phosphorus react with chlorine form phosphorus chloride, sulfur react with chlorine form sulfur chloride. The next is affinity for hydrogen, means how chlorine react with hydrogen. As we all are known, chlorine has great affinity for hydrogen. It react with hydrogen and compound containing hydrogen to form HCl. For example, H2 plus Cl to form 2HCl, H2S plus Cl to form 2HCl plus sulfur. So chlorine having more affinity with hydrogen. Next, reaction with ammonia. Whenever chlorine react with excess of ammonia, it gives ammonium chloride and nitrogen. For example, the quantity of ammonia in excess means 8 and 3 Cl2, it form ammonium chloride and nitrogen. Excess of chlorine react with ammonia, it give nitrogen trichloride, which is explosive. See here in the reaction, ammonia is having one quantity and chlorine is a three quantity, means excess of chlorine is used, so it's formed nitrogen trichloride and with HCl. Now the reaction with alkaline. Whenever chlorine react with cold or dilute alkali, it produces a mixture of chloride and hypochlorite. When reacted with hot concentrated alkali, chloride and chlorate are produced. See here, there is a reaction NaOH cold and diluted. NaOH cold and diluted, chlorine react with cold and diluted NaOH, so it form mixture of chloride, means sodium chloride, and hypochlorite means sodium hypochlorite. When react with hot and concentrated NaOH, so it form chloride means sodium chloride, and chlorate means sodium chlorate. So in a simple way, whenever chlorine react with cold and dilute alkali, it produce mixture of chlorite and hypochlorite. When react with hot concentrated alkali, it form chloride and chlorate. Chlorine when react with dry slaked lime give bleaching powder, and it is the very common reaction for forming of bleaching powder. Calcium hydroxide react with chlorine, it forms CaOl2 plus CaCl2 plus O2H2O. So this CaOCl2 is nothing but a bleaching. Now the next reaction of chlorine with hydrocarbon means alkene. So chlorine react with saturated hydrocarbon to give substitution product, and with saturated means single bonded, and with unsaturated means double bonded hydrocarbon, they give addition product. Means in saturated hydrocarbon substitution reaction is procedure, and with unsaturated hydrocarbon addition reaction is occurred here. Substitution means here CH4, from CH4 one hydrogen is removed and Cl2 one chlorine is added with this CH4, and one hydrogen from this CH4 react with another chlorine. And addition reaction means this two chlorine atom is added with this two CH2 group. Next chemical property of chlorine is oxidizing property. So chlorine oxidizes with ferrous salt and they form ferric salt and sulfide to sulfate. Ferrous to ferric and sulfide to sulfate. And the reactions, both the reactions are there. Next is chlorine oxidizes sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide and iodine to iodate. In presence of water, they form sulfuric acid and iodic acid respectively. Again, the reactions are there. So you have to study these four reactions with the balancing of atom. Last properties of fluorine is the bleaching property, as chlorine requires the presence of moisture for bleaching. It liberates nascent hydrogen from water, which is responsible for its oxidizing and bleaching property. Means for bleaching, chlorine needs water. When water react with chlorine, form HCl and HOCl. This HOCl again break with HCl and form nascent oxygen. Chlorine bleaches vegetable matters or colored organic matter in presence of moisture to colorless matter. So these are the chemical properties of chlorine. Uses: chlorine used for purification of drinking water, for bleaching wood pulp required for manufacture of paper and rayon, bleaching cotton and textile, for extraction of metal like gold and platinum. So these are the uses of chlorine. The next topic in this chapter is interhalogen compound. As we have seen that all halogen molecules are diatomic, They form binary compound with hydrogen with oxygen. They form oxyacid, and with halogen they form interhalogen compound. Although all halogen belong to same group, they have different electronegativities. Due to this differs in electronegativity, two or more halogen atoms combine to form species which may be ionic or neutral. The neutral molecule are called interhalogen compound. For example, CIF BrF3. Interhalogen compound is a compound formed by combination of atom of different halogen. The interhalogen compound is regarded as the halide of more electropositive halogen. A given halogen form an interhalogen compound only with the halogen having lesser electronegativity. Various type of interhalogen compound you can study it from this table. For example, chlorine. So chlorine form different type of interhalogen compound, bromine form different type of interhalogen compound, iodine form different type of interhalogen compound. Now classification. So depending on their composition, interhalogen compounds are classified into four type, which you can study in this table. Four type of interhalogen compound means XX dash, and the example is CLF, BrF, Br, Cl, ICl, Ibr. Example, XX-3, XX-5 and XX-7. These are the classification of interhalogen compound. Means four type of interhalogen compounds are there: XX-3, XX-5 and XX-7. In general, formula XX-N. In place of N, we can use 3, 5 or 7. X is the larger halogen having larger size. X is the larger halogen with a larger size. For example, in this, chlorine is the larger halogen having larger size, and X dash means fluorine is more, sorry, X dash is the halogen having a smaller size. Student, X here in this compound, X is chlorine and X dash is fluorine. So X means chlorine, X means here chlorine, which is larger size and more electropositive. X dash is here fluorine, it is a smaller size and more electronegative. Same here, in any of the compound, X is the larger size and more electropositive, and X dash is the smaller size and more electronegative. The next topic is general characteristic of interhalogen compound. So the general characteristic of interhalogen compound, the compound is considered as a halide, means X. For example, ClF. Here the halogen having larger size is chlorine. It is more electropositive than fluorine, and hence the interhalogen compound is named as chlorine monofluoride. In ClF, chlorine monofluoride, where N is the number of atom X dash attached to X. As the ratio increases, the value of N also increases. Interhalogen compound have even number of atom, means 2, 4, 6, 8. For example, ClF3 has 4 atom. ClF3 has 4 atom. ClF5 has 6 atom. IF7 has 8 atom. Means interhalogen compound have even number of atom. The properties of interhalogen compound are generally intermediate between those of the halogen from which they are made. The central halogen exhibit different oxidation state in different interhalogen compound. Number of X dash. Number of X dash atom in the compound is always odd. They are all diamagnetic. Next topic is state of interhalogen compound at 25 degrees Celsius. For example, ClF. So it is colorless. These are the XX dash. BrF, pale brown color at 25 degrees Celsius. BrCl, gas. ICL, ruby light solid means alpha form, or if it is having brown light solid, so it is beta form. IBR, black solid. Same state of interhalogen compound at 25 degrees Celsius, XX3 and XX5, XX-7 are given here in the table. Means at 25 degrees Celsius, what is the state of interhalogen compound? Next is method of preparation of interhalogen compound. The first method is direct combination. So here we are going to study the preparation of XX- and XX-3. So in XX- direct combination means both in equal volume. For example, chlorine fluorine at equal volume 25 degrees Celsius in copper vessels, iodine chlorine in presence of HCl and HNO3, boil iodine and chlorine, then bromine and chlorine means equal volume of both the halogen react together and form XX-. In XX-3, as we have seen, Cl2 3F2O, so fluorine in excess quantity, so it formed 2ClF3 means XX-3. Bromine react with fluorine, again fluorine in the excess quantity, it form BrF3. Then iodine and chlorine, chlorine in excess quantity, it form ICl3. So it is the first method, means direct combination. Another method, reaction of halogen with interhalogen compound. Again react with halogen with interhalogen compound. For example, Br2 react with BrF3 means XX-3. So it form 3BrF. Then here Br2 react with ClF3. So it form 2BrF3 plus BrCl. Special reaction of ICl means iodine react with potassium chlorate, it form ICl plus potassium iodide. These are the preparation of interhalogen compound. Then properties of XX- and XX-3. First is the thermal stability of XX-. As you have seen the arrow, ClF is greater than ICl, then Br, then BrCl, then BrF. So it is the order for the thermal stability of XX-. Next property is hydrolysis gives oxoacid. Means whenever XX- react with water, the reaction is known as hydrolysis. It form oxoacid. You have seen HOBr, HIO3. These are the oxoacid in X3 also HIO3. These are the oxoacid. Next, disproportionation or autoionization means breaking of element, means BrF3 autoionization is formed 2Br2 plus BrFi. Similar here, ClF3 autoionization is formed 1 plus and 1 minus N. Fluorination. Fluorination occurs in XX3 only, where uranium react with ClF3 and it form UF6 and ClF. Next reaction react with ethene or olefin. See here, addition reaction is occurred here. ICl is added with this olefin and form addition reaction. Next topic is the uses of interhalogen compound of XX- and XX-3. So XX- in XX- ICl is used to determine iodine value of oils. It is used as catalyst for oxidation of AS turn. It is used in preparation of polyhalide. XX-3, it is used for again preparation of polyhalide, fluorinating agent, and as non-aqueous solvent. At the last, from this chapter, is structure of some interhalogen compound. As you have seen in this ICl, iodine monochloride, the central metal atom is iodine, which is joined with two chlorine atom. The shape of this is linear. ClF3, chlorine chloride trifluoride. Band T-shaped structure is there with the bond angle 89 degrees Celsius. ब्रोमीन ट्राइफ्लोराइड. बैंड टिश्यू स्ट्रक्चर इज अगेन देयर विद द बॉन्ड एंगल 86 डिग्री सेल्सियस. BrF5 ब्रोमीन पेंटाफ्लोराइड स्क्वायर पिरामिडल स्ट्रक्चर. ClF5 क्लोरीन पेंटाफ्लोराइड स्क्वायर पिरामिडल स्ट्रक्चर इज ऑल्सो देयर. सो दीज आर दी ऑल अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इंटर हेलोजन कंपाउंड. स्टूडेंट, इट इज़ द चैप्टर ऑफ ग्रुप 16, 17 and 18 and it is the last topic of structure of interhalogen compound. The chapter is in here. Chapter is finished here. I hope you all understand this. Thank you so much.